Hey beautiful people, welcome back to the channel. So to be honest with you, I really don't have anything in mind to talk about today. I really just miss talking to you guys. So I know for those of you who have seen my post about the Q&A that we planned on doing, that we did. We actually recorded it 3 times. Each time something went wrong. One time I lost the footage, the other time we had issues with uploading, and then another time we still have it and we're just trying to get it uploaded, like can't do it to save our lives. But with that being said, I know it's going to be powerful because the enemy is fighting it and he does not want us to get this video out to you guys. And you guys' questions were so good. We were talking about marriage and intimacy, and we were talking about our dating experience and, you know, the sex talk and children, and it was so good. It was so fun to record. But I tell you, like, we still have it and we are not able to upload it, and it's crazy. You guys are going to get 2 videos before you even get the Q&A, and the Q&A we recorded almost 3 months ago, sorry, 3 weeks ago. So I'm sorry that it's jumpy. Like I said, I didn't have any intentions on recording this. I just really missed talking to you guys. You guys don't understand. I get fed just this interaction. It feeds my soul. It's something that I've called to do. I was born to do it. I'm designed to do it. It's in me. And I can tell that because everything in me just responds when I'm talking to you guys. So I have shades on because I look crazy. Yeah, that's what's happening. We're going to keep these bad boys on. I had a meeting this morning and I literally just did the whole meeting like this because, yeah, no time for makeup this morning. Luke isn't feeling too well. He came down with a little fever. So y'all say a prayer for him. You guys are my prayer warriors. You always do. So I thank you for your prayers in advance. But he hasn't been feeling well, so I wasn't going to go to the meeting. And last minute, Ralph and I decided that it's best that I just go to the meeting and he's going to stay home with Luke. So that's what happened. So yeah, nothing to really talk about here. I love you guys. I love you guys so very much. You guys have been on my heart.
Watch out. Vehicle stopped on shoulder ahead.
Okay. So you guys have been on my heart tremendously. I've been praying for you guys. I know that some of you are in the waiting room. I know that some of you are waiting for the Lord to bring you your husband, waiting for the Lord to bring you your children that you've been asking him for, waiting on the Lord to bring financial breakthrough. You're waiting on the Lord for healing, all of these different things, the waiting room, period. And I just pray that you guys keep him at the forefront of your mind, that you guys are not looking at your circumstances, but that you are really, really giving all of yourself to the Lord, sitting at his feet. Sitting at his feet, you are his child, you're his daughter, you're his son. And like any good parent, the word says if our earthly parents can do this, how much more do you think our father would? So if your earthly parents want good things for you, how much more do you think your father would? And how much more do you think your father does? And so keep in mind that there's some things, even down to healing, everything is sovereign. God is sovereign. So everything that's going on, he is in charge of. And I know that in the midst of it, it might seem like, dang, like there's no way he knows this is going on and just allowing it. You'd be very, very surprised. He will make everything that you're going through turn out for your good because you love him and you keep his commandments. Don't forget that part. Okay, so the word says that he turns all things out for our good.
In half a mile.
For those.
Exit right to exit 10B, I-20 West, Birmingham.
For those who love him and keep his commandments. So what you're doing in this season, what you're doing in the waiting room, if you're loving him by being obedient and keeping his commandments and not turning your back on him and not woe is me and complaining, but you're loving him and you're keeping his commandments, don't ever for a second doubt that he is not going to use whatever it is that you're going through for your good. When I was in my previous marriage and I thought that that was the end of me, I thought that this is it. God cannot still be with me. There is no way. I was just so in a horrible, horrible mind space. And it wasn't until I just kept getting back at his feet. And so I'm saying that to you guys. Hold on to what you know is true. what you know is true is that God got you, and there's nothing that he will allow you to go through that he will not use, not only for your good, but he will use that thing for the good of others, for the betterment of others. You will be ministering to people who you never thought you would minister to, but they dealt with or dealing with what you've already overcome. Or they might be dealing with something that you're still dealing with. People come to me all the time telling me, you know, asking for advice, and it's like, Lord, I'm dealing with that myself. But the Holy Spirit gives me what they need, and in the midst of it, I'm being ministered to. Like, Fagan, you gotta do this. You gotta do this. You gotta do this, and not just for you, but for the people who you are called to. You guys motivate me to be a better me. You guys motivate me to constantly grow and change and adapt and transform into the person that God has called me to be. This is a journey. So if you are in the waiting room for whatever you are waiting for, be faithful, meaning you're doing it, not in this funky mindset, like, you know, well, I could just wait. I don't have no other choice but to wait. And then every time something comes up that looks like, you know, a reason for you to get all down and out, you're down and out. And then things look good. Okay, I'm good now. I'm good. And then something else happens and you're back down and out. And it's like, don't be tossed by the wind. Don't go left just because the wind is going left. And then right, when the wind is going right, the Lord is ministering to me about that. My husband and I have started a business. We're about 2.5 years into the business. And it just now started actually doing something. And it took faith, but not only that, but it really helped us. It strengthened our faith muscle. Because it was like, Lord, I know that you put your stamp of approval on this thing, but it is not doing anything. We are not seeing any fruit. My husband has left his job for this. Like, what is going on? And to be honest with you, 99% of the time we were in the waiting room for this business to actually start being fruitful was positive. We were kept and we were taken care of. And it wasn't a lot of murmuring, and it wasn't a lot of complaining, and it wasn't a lot of looking at everybody else and seeing everybody else succeed and then feeling like sorry for yourself. It wasn't a lot of that. I'm telling you, I'm truthfully telling you this. Y'all know that I'm transparent and open. I would tell you if I was in the waiting room like the, you know, the people of Egypt acting crazy, but I wasn't. I was in the waiting room. My husband and I was in the waiting room so faithful. Every time something went bad, we would be like, okay, it's just one more thing. One more thing that needs to go bad, and get that out of the way so we can get to the promised land. So I'm just telling you guys, be faithful in the waiting room. Be faithful in the waiting room. Be diligent. Keep your words right. You know, don't look at everybody else and comparing yourself. Comparison is the joy stealer. Comparison is the faith stealer. It will steal your joy and faith like this. Surround yourself with people who are above you, people who are not above you, but who are where you want to be, who have found some measure of success. Get rid of those who are not. Get rid of those people who are pulling you down. Get rid of the people in the relationships that are stagnant. Get rid of the relationships that are causing you to question yourself and causing you to think, well, maybe I shouldn't be doing this. Maybe I need to conform and do what everybody else is doing. Get rid of those people. Get rid of the people that is constantly... Get rid of the people who want to be rid of. There are people in your life that may very well want to leave. They're showing you signs that they don't want to be in your life, but out of convenience, they're there. Out of just the sake of relationship, because you're a good person to talk to every now and again, they stay. Both of y'all know that this person should be out of your life, but you're keeping and holding on to something just for the heck of it. And trust me and believe me when I say this, that there are things that you might be waiting for in the waiting room. You're waiting for these things, and it can be very well that it's not so much that God is waiting on something to happen, or, you know, you're waiting on God to do something. It's more so there's people that cannot go where you are destined to go. There are people who cannot reap the benefits of the things that you're supposed to reap, of the benefits that you're supposed to reap of the thing that you're waiting on God for, if that makes sense. You cannot take them with you. And people say that, and they look at that in like a cliche way, like, well, you can't take people with you on the next level. You know, yeah, but you really have to think about, there's mindsets, there's things that are in them that is going to damage the thing that's in you. Okay? There are curses that are on people that if they go with you into the next season, that you're going to be figuring out, why is this problem for me? Why is this thing seem like it's following me? Because that person is following you. So I don't know who that is for. But let people go. When they want to go, let them go. And I'm speaking to myself because I'm in the same situation. Saddened and crying over somebody who just don't want to be in my life. Who seems like they've rejected me. And to be truth be told, it caused me to question myself. It caused me to say, well, Fagan, are you the reason why they don't want to be around you? And just because I was able to do that and go and seek the Lord about that, He made sure that He answered me quickly when it came to that. Because I was humble enough. My pastor teaches that, and he preaches that, and he walks that. Be humble enough to look inward. And so I was humble enough to say, okay, well, don't subscribe to the fact that, well, if somebody don't want to be with you, it's because of them. No, that's not always the case. So I asked myself, Lord, is it me? Why do I feel like, you know, I don't have a friend? And friend, you know who you are, and trust me and believe me, I love y'all. But there's a difference between having friends and having someone close. And I'm like, why don't I have that right now? Is it me? Have I ran people away? And I went to the Lord and asked Him that. And it almost started making me sad. And my husband, I said, you know, I didn't tell him this part, but I said, I don't know why, but this person she just doesn't want to be in my life right now. And he said, Fagan, don't ever look at that as a negative thing. Where are you in your life? You're in a transition. And the Holy Spirit reminded me that every single time, this is for someone, every single time I am in a transition in my life, the people around me change. Every single time I'm in a transition, the bigger the transition, the bigger the change. The bigger the transition, more people drop off. The bigger the transition, more people come on. My circle starts to change. The things I start doing, I'm leaving a meeting right now that I would have never thought I was a part of. I was in a room with some heavy hitters. So here I am 2 days before this, crying over spilled milk, crying over a relationship that a person that doesn't want to be in my life. But here I am today in a room with people. Not only are they financially successful, but they have goals and they have achievements and they are full of integrity and they know some things and they're willing to teach some things and with no strings attached. I just left a room like that. So what am I really crying over? Yes, I did a video on about this before. Yes, there are times where you're just sad because you really just miss the person. But the Lord knows my personality. And I am very big on, Lord, if it's not for me, take it. I'll cry about it for a second, but I'm not going to cry for long. My mother taught me that. Cry about it and then get over it. Don't sit there and cry and woe is me. You're wasting really good time. So yeah, it had me sad the other day. I'm telling you, I was like, I've never felt like this. Usually when people leave and I leave people, like I feel okay. But this one really hurt. And the Lord said, Fagan, you are going to feel that. And not only are you going to feel that now, but you're going to feel that later. And you didn't do anything. And He had to tell me that. Fagan, you didn't do anything. I'm looking back on a relationship. What did I do? What did I say? Did I do that? I was hurt. I heard from you. I did it. And if you didn't do anything, let it go. So guys, I don't know, you know, God is good. Holy Spirit be doing His thing. I didn't really know what this video was going to be about, but I know all of those things hit home for someone. Hit home for someone. And it's all worth it. Guys, it's imperative that we build a relationship with the Lord so that we can learn these things and how He moves in our lives and patterns and all types of things. So that is it and that is all. I'm gonna go now. I love you guys. Look, I'm gonna let you see my face. I love you guys. I love you guys. I love you enough to let you see my no eyebrows. Jesus, take the wheel. I'm laying hands on my eyebrows, y'all. Since I was a little girl, I haven't had any, so I draw mine on every chance I get. But I love you guys. And I will be hopefully in another video sooner than later. And we can reconvene about some things. So keep in mind that that video, that Q&A will be up soon. Okay, I'm not that bold. I'm going to put these back on. So the Q&A will be up soon. And hopefully you guys really enjoy that. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't. And thumbs up the video if you enjoyed it. And I will see you in the next one, which is probably going to be tomorrow. Love you. Bye.